Welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to give you an overview of all the existing transactions in the SAP system. I will explain you how you can find easily new transactions in the SAP system. And finally, I would like to give you an ABAP report that you can use to find transaction codes in SAP ERP and SAP S4HANA. Have fun and let's get started. So first of all, we can search for transactions and get an overview of all the existing transaction codes in a specific database table. For that, we have to open up the data browser. In the top left corner in the command field there, we can enter the transaction code SE16N. You can also use the transaction SE16 or SE16H. I personally prefer the transaction code SE16N. When I enter the transaction code, I enter here in the general table display, and in here under table, I have to enter the table TSTC. If I enter that, then here you will have the ability to search for all the existing transaction codes in the SAP system. And if you delete the maximum number of hits, then you will get an overview and a list of all of the existing transaction codes in the SAP system. If you want to search for transactions, then you can use the text table TSTCT. So there you can enter it. There you can enter your language, for example, EN for English. And under text, there you can enter your text that you would like to use in order to search for transaction codes. For example, I would like to search for all the transaction codes which contain ABAP in the text. So I enter ABAP. I use a wildcard search, so I put an asterisk in front and behind my search term, and with the F8 key on your keyboard or with this button, there you can execute the search. Now you will see all the existing transaction codes which contain ABAP in the transaction text. If you would like to know how many transactions you have in the SAP system, then we can go one step back. And here we can enter once again the TSTC table, and then we can just simply click on this button number of entries, or you could also use the key F7 on your keyboard. And once I've clicked this, then over here I see that I have almost 150,000 transactions in the SAP system. This totally depends which kind of SAP modules are installed, but there you can find it quite easily. So basically, there are three common ways how you can display your transaction codes that you have executed and is currently running. So to show you this, I switch to another transaction code, to the transaction data browser, the transaction code SE16N. And now we have three ways to display this transaction code. The first one is in the repository data under system and status. And in here you will get very useful and a lot important information about your system. And under SAP data and repository data, there you will see the transaction code which is currently running. In this case, it's the SE16N. I will close this for a second. The next way to show you the transaction code is in the bottom right corner over here, where you can open the system information. I will open them, and here you will also see the running transaction code. If you don't see this transaction code, then you have to switch your displayed information. So for my case, now the transaction code is showing, and I can switch it if I click on this dark triangle, and then here you have the ability to switch to different information, for example, to the transaction. You can also, if you want to, switch to another information by just clicking on the information you like, and then this will be changed. But in my case, and I totally recommend to use the transaction down here. The third option is in the start menu in the SAP Success menu. So to show you this, I will switch back to the start menu, and here you have a nice tree structure of all the existing transactions structured in different folders. For example, if I open up the Office folder, there you will see different transactions, for example, the SAP WP, the SAP Business Workplace. And if I double click on this transaction, then it is opened up, it is executed, and you will jump to this transaction. Maybe this transaction code is not showing in your case. You can display this transaction code under extras, under settings, or you could also use the key combination Shift and F9. And here with the checkbox display technical names, there you can turn on the technical names in the tree structure. So for example, if I deselect this, then this transaction code is gone. If I again go under extra settings, then I can activate it once again. Now it is showing. And to search for transactions, there you can enter in the command field search underscore SAP underscore menu. And there a pop-up occurs where you can enter a search text. And for my case, I just want to show up all the nodes, all the transaction codes, which contain ABAP in the name. And so I enter ABAP, I execute the search by clicking on this button, or you could also use the enter key on your keyboard. And then here you will also see the existing nodes in the tree structure where ABAP is in. So for example, the ABAP workbench, the ABAP program, and so on. This is also useful and recommended to use. You can copy this transaction by clicking on it, or you could also use the key combination Control Y to select and to copy with Control C this value. Furthermore, you could use the maintenance transaction for transactions. And you can enter up this transaction in the command field with the transaction code SE93. And there you will enter in a transaction for maintaining transactions. And in here you could use the for help to search for existing transactions in the SAP system. So you could just use the F4 key on your keyboard or click on this button. And there for my case, I see the previously inputted transaction codes, and I can use the information system button or the 5 key on my keyboard to search for transaction codes. And in here I could also enter ABAP and then enter this search to search for existing transactions in the system. In my German-speaking SAP blog, ERP-up, I have published an article about these options, and at the bottom I have published an ABAP coding for searching for existing transaction codes. So you could also use this ABAP code to set up an ABAP report in the transaction SE38. So you could just copy this clipboard, jump over to the SAP system SE38, enter this code, activate the report, and then you could also search for transaction codes in the system. Thanks for watching. I hope you have learned a lot. You can now find and search for existing transaction codes in the system. Hit the like button, add a comment, and subscribe for free, and see you in the next video.